This video was made in collaboration with Narutopedia. For more information, check out the link in the description. The Life of Shino Aburame from Naruto. Shino Aburame is a shinobi of Konohagakure's Aburame clan. Quiet and at times off-putting to some, Shino puts his clan's insect-based techniques to use on Team Kurenai. Welcome to the Amagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Shino Aburame. Before we begin, we publish a new video every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. The Amagi's reach stretches beyond just this channel, so if you're a fan of us, please consider subscribing to our other channels and following us on all of our social media. Help us reach our goal of passing 100,000 followers on all of our accounts by the end of the year. And with that out of the way, let's get into the video. Background. Shino at one time grew up alongside Torune Aburame as his family took him in under guardianship after Torune's father, Shikuro Aburame, passed away. Despite their different views about friendship, Shino grew close to Torune, viewing him as an older brother. One day, Danzo Shimura approached the two young Aburame with the desire to recruit another young member of a secret technique using clan for root. While Danzo had the authority to do so and expressed interest in Shino, not wanting Shino to live a life of loneliness, Torune offered himself, appealing to Danzo by revealing who his father was. Knowing that he would probably never see Torune again, but wanting to remain close to his brother figure in some way, Shino harvested some of Torune's insects and spent years refining his bug breeding technique to produce new beetles that inherited traces of Torune's insects. After enrolling in the academy and being placed in Iruka Umino's class, he met Kiba Inuzuka, whom he numerously became irritated at due to the pair having polar opposite personalities. During breaks in between classes, he would let his bugs walk on his desk. During a class training session, he watched on alongside Kiba as Shikamaru Nara and Choji Akamichi refused to fight each other even during training. When Kiba commented that Shikamaru, who had found the process to be too troublesome, would be a genin for the rest of his life, Shino noted that that may not be so, as Shikamaru could go on to live a long life and many things could happen. But before he could finish his statement, Kiba cut him off. Chunin exams. While Shino originally made several background appearances during Prologue, Land of Waves, in the anime, his official debut was just before the beginning of the Chunin Exams arc, when the Rookie Nine came together. In the first part of the Chunin Exams, Shino used his insects to read the answers on other people's tests. During the second part, his knowledge of insects allowed his team to take another team's scroll with little effort. When leeches attacked another team, they stumbled into a net trap. Kiba wanted to acquire yet another scroll, but Shino and Hinata disapproved. However, they went along. While keeping cover, he and his teammates soon spotted the three sand siblings confronting some Ame Nin. They watched as Gaara killed the Ame Nin's leader, and despite the other Ame Nin surrendering, he killed them as well. Gaara apparently knew they were there, but his siblings persuaded him to move onwards. Later, when his team reached the tower, they saw the sand siblings once again, leaving a chilly vibe as they walked by. During the preliminary matches of the Chunin exams, Shino was matched against Zaku Abumi. Because one of Zaku's arms was in a sling, Shino advised him to forfeit the match. Zaku refused and instead attacked Shino with his one good arm. In attacking Shino, Shino was given an opportunity to box Zaku in with bugs, forcing Zaku to choose between attacking him or attacking the bugs, leaving the other to attack Zaku from behind. Zaku chose to attack both and pulled his other arm out of its sling. As Zaku prepared to blast the two opposing forces, his arms detonated, making them unusable and putting him in immense pain. As Zaku writhed, Shino revealed that the tubes in Zaku's arms had been filled with bugs, causing the pressure of Zaku's attack to go inward when it couldn't escape. Shino was scheduled to fight against Konkoro in the final rounds, but Konkoro forfeited before their match began to avoid revealing the secrets of his puppet Karasu. Konoha Crush. When Konkoro fled the village, Shino followed him, apparently having managed to dispel the sleep-inducing genjutsu that spread throughout the stadium and wanting the fight that he had been denied. Shino caught up with Konkoro about to fight with Sasuke, allowing Sasuke to continue on pursuing Gaara while they had their match. Konkoro attacked Shino from a distance with his puppet, and Shino used his bugs to make otherwise impossible evasions. A poisonous gas attack, however, caught Shino by surprise. Although he was able to avoid the worst of it, Shino breathed in some of the gas by accident. As the battle progressed, Shino used his bugs to eat away the chakra strings that Konkoro used to control his puppet, forcing him to relinquish and reacquire control of his only weapon. All the while, Shino directed his bugs to the scent of a female bug placed upon Konkoro's forehead protector, and upon reaching Konkoro, they consumed his chakra. As Konkoro collapsed due to the sapping of his strength, Shino collapsed too, the poisonous gas taking effect on his system. After regaining consciousness, Shino found his father, Shibi Aburame, standing over him, using his own bugs to draw out the poison in Shino's body. He is later seen at the Third Hokage's funeral alongside the other villagers, mourning his death. Sasuke Recovery Mission. Shino regretted being away with his father on a mission and therefore unable to help. Shino felt that had he been able to help, the mission's outcome might have been different, and Sasuke might have not been able to abandon the village. Putting the past behind him, Shino resorted to working on his teamwork skills with Kiba and Hinata, helping the latter to improve her abilities. In Naruto's Footsteps, The Friends' Paths. In the anime, about 2 years after Naruto left the village to train with Jiraiya, Konoha decided to host an early Chunin exams alongside Tsunagakure. Upon entering the exams, Shino and his teammates were randomly split into different rooms to take the written test. He was placed in room 2 with Ino and Lee. On a monitor, Shikamaru as proctor explained that everyone only needs to answer one question on the test, but their team's combined score must equal exactly 100 points to pass. While Shino suddenly had one of his insects survey the room, he noticed that one of the participants, Fu, had a chakra essence similar to a bug user, but showed no signs of being one. After hearing vibrations through the wall, Shino figured out that someone was trying to deliver a message of what question to pick up by the number of vibrations. After time was up, Shikamaru revealed a bonus question, which asked what teammate you would sacrifice as a decoy, and the answer had to be unanimous. The person picked, however, would be disqualified. He and his team decided not to answer, and ultimately they passed the first round. However, since there were more participants than expected, a preliminary round had to be issued, which involved a race to Suna, where only the first 30 teams to arrive at the destination would qualify for the second phase. Ultimately, his team were among the first 30 teams to make it. The following day, the second exam began. Like the last exam in Konoha, the teams were all given either a Heaven or Earth scroll, and were required to obtain the missing scroll within 3 days. They were then required to bring the set to the main building in the center of the Demon Desert. Following a simple plan by Kiba, Team Kurenai began talking loudly for all to hear, waiting for someone with a Heaven Scroll to come to them. Ultimately, the Kusanin team came after them. Shino faced off with Muyami, and the two equally quiet ninjas stared each other down. As Shino began dodging Muyami's underground assaults, the enemy was able to steal the Earth Scroll from Kiba and retreated with it. While escaping Hinata's sight and blocking Kiba's smell respectively, Shino set one of his female insects on the enemy to track. While pursuing the enemy, Shino and his teammates fell into a quicksand pit. Akamaru, however, was able to use his dynamic marking to solidify the sand enough for the team to escape. Once recovered, Team Kurenai resumed their pursuit of the enemy. As Kiba and Akamaru continued following the scent, they soon found it multiplied and scattered throughout the area. When Shino's bugs failed to find the enemies as well and suggested going after other enemy scrolls, Kiba, finding to his annoyance, thinking about Naruto again, became determined not to fail. Then realizing that Burami's scent was on his clothes from the earlier scuffle, Kiba decided to use it to find the real enemy. While back on the trail again, the enemies ambushed Team Kurenai. While initially overwhelmed, the team swapped out of the predicament with Shino's insect clones, allowing them to regroup. Seeing their enemy's tactics, Team Kurenai quickly pressured the Kusonin before Kiba finished them off with his three-headed wolf technique, earning Team Kurenai a Heaven and Earth scroll. Later, they were caught in a massive sandstorm. Ultimately, the team was rescued by the Suna-nin proctors and brought to a building to wait out the storm before resuming the exams. After the storm passed and the second exam was concluded, it was learned that the Chunin exams were ended early due to controversy happening in the second exam. Instead, it was decided by Gaara that a report on each participant would be sent to their respective village leader, for them to decide if they'd be promoted. Upon returning to the village, Shino and his teammates were all promoted to Chunin status. Tenshi Bridge Reconnaissance Mission. After Naruto's 2.5 years of training was done, he returned to the village. Shortly after Naruto's mission to rescue Gaara, he went looking for help in another mission to find Sasuke. He ran into Shino, who at first he failed to recognize, only remembering him from his annoying way of talking, as Shino does not seem to notice his outfit makes it hard for people who have not seen him in a while to recognize him. When Naruto immediately recognized Kiba and Hinata, however, Shino took to sulking with his back turned, apparently hurt that Naruto hadn't recognized him. Neither Shino nor his teammates were able to help Naruto as their team had already accepted a mission. Akatsuki Suppression Mission. In the anime, Shino is seen at Asuma Sarutobi's funeral, mourning his loss along with the rest of the village. Itachi Pursuit Mission. When Kakashi needed to build a squad for the hunt for Itachi Uchiha, he added the members of Team 8 to his 8-man squad. Fated Battle Between Brothers. When the 8-man squad encountered Tobi, Shino took charge of the fight to make up for not having been available to retrieve Sasuke the first time. Even though he was able to completely encase Tobi in his bugs, Tobi escaped and was subsequently able to get to Sasuke before them. Six Tails Unleashed. On his way back from a failed mission for locating Itachi Uchiha with the rest of the 8-man squad, Katsuyu stopped them in their tracks. He, Kakashi, and his teammates returned to the village while Team Yamato went to fulfill their new mission given by Katsuyu from the 5th Hokage, Pain's Assault. During the initial assault and the chaos created by Pain upon assaulting the village, Shino along with his teammates watched in shock. Shino later left them to meet up with his father and other clan members. He joins Muda, his father, and another unnamed member of his clan in confronting Konan. They use their Kikaichu to eat the paper that Konan had wrapped several shinobi in while Katsuyu healed them. Shino then tells his father that he would give his all to eradicate the enemy. The anime expands on this battle, and the Aburame can be seen launching a surprise overhead assault on her. However, this turns out to be just a clone. As they look up, they realize that they are surrounded by clones of Konan, who descend on them. Shino and his clansmen send their bugs to destroy the clones, who, to their surprise, detonate. They later realize that explosive tags have been placed in the clones. As they narrowly escape the explosion, Konan, who had drenched herself in water to counter the effects of fire and mixed herself in with the clones, can be seen walking out of the flames. Later, in the anime, the four Aburame had been seen emerging from underneath rubble after Diva Path completely levels the village. Later, he went back to celebrate Naruto's victory over Pain with the other villagers. 5 Kage Summit. After Sasuke has been branded an international criminal and is marked for death, Shino wonders if they should tell Naruto and Sakura about the situation between them and Sasuke if Ino is in a tough situation. Shikamaru then decides that he will tell them. As the other members of the Konoha 11 are determined to kill Sasuke and prevent him from descending any lower and dragging the village into a terrible international war as a result, Shino is also prepared to do so. Shino was later seen with the rest of the Konoha 11, hearing Naruto's decision about Sasuke, arguing how they can't always just let Naruto handle things on his own, especially since Sasuke's criminal actions have caused all of Konoha to be involved. 4th Shinobi World War. Confrontation. Shino was placed in the 5th Division. He stated that his team should avoid drawing attention to themselves, to which Ino assured him that it won't be difficult. After Kitsuchi and Kurotsuchi blew the White Zetsu Army out of the ground, Shino used his secret technique Insect Sphere to attack them. Shino states that not only are the White Zetsu Army strong, they're durable as well, and says that if this keeps up, it'll end up being a war of attrition. After the first day of fighting, Shino is seen alive along with Kiba, Akamaru, Hinata, and Neji. Later, while Neji rests and Hinata takes on Neji's duties as a lookout, Shino tells her not to overexert herself. He has bugs scattered all over the area. Later, Shino's insects notify him of another Aburame appearing in the battlefield, appearing to be another reincarnated shinobi. Upon finding him, Shino is shocked to find out that it's Torune. Torune explains that he is nearly finished forcibly completing his most forbidden technique, which will poison a great portion of the allied shinobi. Torune begs Shino to get help, but Shino insists that only he can stop his childhood friend. As the two battle, they find themselves catching up on each other's lives. Torune genuinely glad how Shino turned out. One of Naruto's clones then arrives to help. As Torune nearly hits clone Naruto with his toxic punch, Shino steps in to take the hit, revealing that his newest insects can repel the toxins of Torune. Using them to pin down Torune, Shino then applies a sealing tag to finally subdue him. Before joining clone Naruto to help their allies, Shino thanks Torune for all his help. Upon hearing that Hinata was in trouble, Shino heads towards her, alongside Kiba, Akamaru, and Neji. He later mobilizes with Naruto and the others to finish the rest of the enemy forces. 4th Shinobi World War, Climax. After being informed by Inoichi from HQ that Naruto and B were fighting the masked Madara, Shino and the rest of the Konoha 11 rush to his aid. As he runs, he states that he would flawlessly support Naruto with his power. Upon arriving at the battlefield, Shino and a few other Aburame immediately use the insect jamming technique in tandem with the Kirinin's hiding in mist technique to obscure their position on the battlefield. He and the other members of the allied shinobi forces later stood to face their opposition. After the failed attempt to immobilize the Ten Tails, Shino and the others braced themselves as the beast emerged from the hole it had been trapped in. He later listened on as Shikaku Nara imparted what would be his final strategy to the Alliance. Shino later looked on in shock after learning of Neji's death. He would later rally to Naruto and Sakura's location after Sasuke Uchiha arrived on the battlefield to confront his former comrade. Utterly shocked by the Uchiha's declaration that he'd become Hokage, Shino brought up the point that his crimes that he had committed would not be easily forgiven nor forgotten. Later, he followed Kiba's determination to join the fight after watching Team 7's display and used the parasitic giant insect bug bite technique, defeating several of the Ten-Tails mini-clones. Afterwards, he watched Naruto and Sasuke attack the Ten-Tails while silently willing them on in the background. Birth of the Ten-Tails Jinchuriki. With the situation looking grim as the Alliance was trapped in a barrier with a tailed beast ball firing tree, Shino and the other shinobi soon found themselves shrouded in the previous version 1 mantles again. He and the others subsequently found themselves on the outside of the barrier, escaping the near-fatal attack thanks to Naruto and Minato's action. As he stood with his teammates, Shino noted that it appeared that they had been teleported. When a recovered Shikamaru later made his ambitions to become the next Hokage's advisor known, Shino informed Akamaru that it was alright as the Hokage could have up to 3 advisors when Akamaru seemed disconcerted by Kiba's expressed intention of having Shikamaru become his advisor if he takes the position of Hokage. Responding when Naruto called for them telepathically, Shino, the other Konoha 11, excluding Neji and Sakura, and Sai are shocked when Naruto's tailed beast mode mantle forms around them as well when he enters one of Kurama's tails. With his directives clear, Shino and the others use the Rasengan which Naruto had formed to break down Obito's defense and give Sasuke and Naruto a clear shot at attacking their opponent. Shino and his comrades, who had reverted to their version 1 states, later aided Naruto in his attempt to extract the tailed beast's chakra from within Obito in order to stop the tree form of the Ten Tails from blooming. After Madara was revived, Shino and the others were confronted by Tobi. When the battle ended abruptly, a perturbed Shino questioned Kiba when he looked into the moon after noticing Akamaru's franticness. When the infinite Tsukuyomi was activated, Shino and the others fell victim to the genjutsu. Inside the genjutsu, Shino dreamt of finding a new giant-sized insect species that he tames. Kaguya Otsutsuki strikes. Later, Shino and the rest of the world are freed by Naruto and Sasuke after ending the war. Kakashi Hiden, lightning in the icy sky. Shino is part of the team of Konoha ninja assigned to provide security at the Blood Prison. When the Ryuha Armament Alliance stages a prison break, Shino helps round up the escaped prisoners. The last, Naruto the movie. Shino makes an appearance in this film set 2 years after the events of the 4th Shinobi World War. He's seen eating ramen with Kiba amongst Naruto's fangirls at Ichiraku. During Toneri Otsutsuki's attack, Shino, Kiba, and Akamaru were assigned to his search and rescue team. Konoha Hiden, the perfect day for a wedding. Shino appears alongside Kiba as they plan to get their teammate Hinata a great wedding present, but realize they cannot come up with a proper idea. Needing Kuranai's advice, they pay her a visit, and Shino is startled that the young Mirai Sarutobi sees him as Uncle Buggy, making Shino wonder about his image. Kuranai suggests the two get the couple some mead, which is found in Soraku, despite the fact that Naruto and Hinata are non-alcoholic. With no other ideas, Shino agrees and heads off, not before Kuranai requests a bottle for herself. In Soraku, Shino sits aside as Kiba and Akamaru get in fights with a Nineko, Momo, until he is shocked to see Kiba in a love-struck stupor with Tamaki's arrival. As she agrees to take them to the bamboo forest that houses the enigmatic beekeeper, Shino comforts the saddened Akamaru who is horrified by Kiba's obvious intense mutual affections for Tamaki. In the bamboo forest, Shino is separated from the others in the magic fog and is attacked by the beekeeper. However, Shino reveals he's immune to poisons thanks to breeding a new breed of Kikaichu from Torane's bugs. After revealing he is not an Iwa shinobi sent to kill them, the beekeeper apologizes and gives Shino the mead free of charge. As the two fellow bug users discuss things, the beekeeper admits that they have been lost for some time, and upon realizing Shino is actually very insecure about his future, since Kuranai, Hinata, and now even Kiba have found love while he hasn't, offers Shino a place in their beehive operation. While Shino considers the offer, he realizes that since this is the last mission of Team 8 and he must complete it for Hinata, he is given renewed vigor. Seeing through the magic fog, Shino pleads with the beekeeper to see through their pity, escape the fog, and live amongst humanity again. Inspired, the beekeeper acknowledges that Shino is very much like a teacher, which appears to set him on his future path. He later attends Naruto and Hinata's wedding with Kiba. Academy Entrance Arc. 10 years after the 4th Shinobi World War, Shino becomes the homeroom teacher for the New Year's Academy student. During the entrance ceremony, he and the other instructors were left mortified when Boruto Uzumaki crashed a train into the Hokage Rock. 2 weeks later, after Boruto's suspension was over, Shino put Boruto through a series of practice drills to having him catch up with the rest of the class, ultimately ranking him as second in the class. Later, as Shino began to start class, he was shocked to see all his students were missing, having gone to watch a fight between Boruto and Iwabi Yuino. Later, Shino began teaching his class shuriken jutsu, only to be discouraged when they weren't listening to his instructions and merely began throwing around their shuriken. After Boruto caused a commotion with a Fuma shuriken, which he ultimately dragged Inojin, Yamanaka, Shikadai, Nara, Medali, and Iwabi into, Shino decided to send the students to perform community work on aiding repairs to the Hokage Rock. Later, during a class designed to introduce students to summoning techniques, Shino had Konohamaru Sarutobi summon a giant toad to demonstrate the more advanced applications of this technique. Later, the class gained a new transfer student from Otogakure named Mitsuki. As tensions started to rise between Mitsuki and the other students, Shino went to Kurenai for advice. She assured him that while teaching isn't his specialty, he knows from experience that one must persevere using their own strength. Inspired by this, wanting the students to warm up to Mitsuki, Shino organized a welcome party for the new student the following day. When Shino's efforts for the party backfired with his insect, the class began to freak out, with Denki begging someone to make the insects go away, which Mitsuki did with his wind release breakthrough, causing even more damage to the academy. As the students began absentmindedly belittling Shino's worth as a ninja and teacher, a distraught Shino took the day off. Upon his return, he was horrified to see that the academy suffered even more damage. As Shino continued to doubt himself, wondering how he can effectively teach the students, a dark specter suddenly possessed Shino, making him give in to his darkest impulses. The following day, he told Mitsuki, Boruto, and Shikadai to meet him in the training field. Once all there, he voiced his plan to get rid of them. Shino then encased the entire area with his insects, forcing the students to flee. After a prolonged chase, Shikadai devised a plan to stop the rampaging sensei. While Shikadai and Boruto distracted Shino and lured him into the water, Mitsuki ensnared Shino and electrocuted him, expelling the specter. As Shino voiced his decision to resign as teacher despite being possessed, the students convinced him to reconsider, apologizing for their early statements. Later, Shino assigned his class to choose a workplace within Konohagakure to get a better understanding of non-shinobi life. Knowing that Boruto, Mitsuki, and Shikadai were determined to continue patrolling the village for their own personal mission, he subtly convinced them to try the postal service. Later, Shino checked on some of his students after learning that they were hospitalized from a recent attack. While blaming himself for putting his students in that situation, Chocho insisted that there was no way of knowing this would happen. Afterwards, as Naruto realized that his son and his friends were conducting their own investigation on the attacks, he insisted that they stay out of the matter. Shino, however, seeing firsthand how capable his students were, insisted that Naruto trust them as kids have a way of surprising adults. As Naruto finally agreed, Shino added that his students would not be reckless in their efforts. When the culprit behind the attacks in the village was revealed to be Sumire, a unit was deployed to apprehend her. The rogue student unleashed Nue onto the village. While Kakashi organized the unit to defend from its attack, Shino worked with a unit to treat the injured. Several weeks later, Shino decided to change up the three-man teams for the next challenge to determine the optimum pairings for graduation. After class, Shino went to talk to Iruka about Sumire's fate, as she turned herself in as the culprit behind the attacks. While Shino insisted to let her return under his supervision, Iruka noted that even with the leniency she got, the choice to return is ultimately up to her. Shino afterwards went to meet with her, who was still in a detention cell. While Sumire was ashamed to look at her teacher, Shino made clear he holds no ill feelings towards her. He encouraged her to find her own path now and offered to help. Later, Shino began preparing his class for the tree climbing practice. On the day of the test, Denki and Iwabi were late for the test. When they finally arrived and explained how they helped save children from a burning building, Shino was amazed at the story. Proud at how the two so effectively applied their studies of chakra-induced climbing, he chose to pass them without any further testing. Sarada Uchiha Arc. As graduation exams approach within a week, Shino begins explaining to his students the significance of it. Naruto Shinden, Parent and Child Day. Shino was spotted by Boruto feeding a toy Kurama doll food pills as he talked to it and said he considered the toy an important part of his family, much to his embarrassment once he realized Boruto was watching him. He tried to convince him that the public display of affection was out of research rather than truly finding the doll cute, which he immediately took back once Boruto left. Whilst once again playing with his doll, he was caught by Sasuke, who thanks him for supporting Sarada during her time at the academy. The two discussed Sarada before Sasuke offended Shino due to his language regarding insects. School Trip Arc. In the anime, to improve relationships with other villages and symbolically show the warring era was over, the 7th Hokage set up an official class trip for the academy to go to Kirigakure. Upon arriving, they were met with Kagura Karatachi, who was appointed by the Mizukage to act as the class's tour guide. The class was later brought to meet Chojuro, the 6th Mizukage. Later, Shino and Anko met with Mei to talk about the growing conflict between the Land of Water and neighboring countries. As the Land of Water wishes to expand military power to the bordering seas, Mei feared that this could escalate into war again. Despite this, Mei assured them that Kirigakure was strongly against all this and that she, with the 6th Mizukage, would work to prevent it all. After the class returned from the trip, Shino delivered a letter from the 6th Mizukage to Iruka about the events, learning that Boruto, Sarada, and Iwabi aided Chojuro in stopping a coup d'etat. When confronting his students about it, after Boruto tried to get out of trouble with a long-winded story, Iruka had the three students repaint a classroom as punishment, which Shino oversaw. Graduation Exams Arc. As ninja classes prepared for the upcoming graduation exams, in addition to Shino being a proctor for said exams, he also began interviewing the different students to discuss their goals as ninja. During the exams, Shino subtly offers his students the chance to steal the answers for the written test. Later, during the practical and final test, the class was brought to the training field. While the teachers would still evaluate the students' respective improvements, the students' true test was against Kakashi Hatake. The 6th Hokage quickly explained that he would only pass the first student who was able to take the single bell attached to his hip. As the test began, Shino intercepted Mitsuki and Boruto. Mitsuki chose to hold off Shino while Boruto went on to find Kakashi, something that Shino noted was a change in Mitsuki's nature. As the two fought, Mitsuki managed to destroy Shino's marker, eliminating him from the test. Mitsuki noted that Shino held back, which Shino responded that using his best tactics would risk killing his student. At the end of the test, Kakashi chose to pass all the students for showing true loyalty and teamwork. Afterwards, Shino released his technique on everyone's headbands, revealing them to be their respective Konoha forehead protectors, proof of their new status as genin. Later, proud of his students for all passing, he assigned them each to their respective genin teams, reminding them that they must always remember teamwork. Versus Momoshiki Arc. He, along with Tenten, proctor for the second phase of the Chunin exams, watching from a monitor as the genin try to capture each other's flag. Later, to encourage his students to take taijutsu training more seriously, he asked Might Guy to give a lecture, during which Shino suggested that Guy demonstrate his points on taijutsu with a brief sparring match against some of the students, knowing that the taijutsu master's old injury wouldn't impede him. Time Slip Arc. After Shino and Kiba stopped a shoplifter from escaping, they bumped into Boruto and Sarada, who were hoping to find the Icha Icha books by Jiraiya in hopes to understand his influence on Naruto. Concerned about such young kids reading such an adult book, the older ninja tried to get them off the topic by telling them from his own experience the kind of man Jiraiya was. When that failed, they simply told the kids that they were too young to read the books. Later, the grown-up Sasuke and Boruto were sent back in time to shortly after Sasuke's defection. There, the two pretended to be traveling performers and were put under watch by Naruto, during which past Shino and his friends helped Boruto and Naruto clean up a bathhouse after the commotion Naruto and Jiraiya caused. Days later, Konohamaru, Moegi, and Udon approached Shino and his friends for help, telling how Naruto and Boruto were battling a dangerous foe. They quickly agreed to help. By the time they arrived, however, Urashiki was already defeated. The group then escorted their injured friends to the hospital. Days later, after Sasuke and Boruto recovered and prepared to return to their time, Sasuke first used his Sharingan to erase the memories of everyone he and Boruto came into contact with of the recent events to protect the timeline. Ao Arc. In the anime, Shino attended the memorial service for the fallen people of the 4th Shinobi World War. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.